Alex from South Central Houston has a question about shiplap insulation.
Boy, does he. He says we are renovating this 1930 pier and beam home.
That's a lot of renovation.
It's a whole bunch of renovation right there. He says it's a one-story house and will be a rental property. We gutted the inside after removing the sheetrock. Much of the shiplap was termite damaged or rotted, so we're replacing it along with the rotted studs. Now, he says, I'm being told that I should add insulation, but thought it better to let the exterior sheathing and shiplap breathe to avoid sweating and rotting. The exterior, he says, Tom, is brick, which seems like a good insulator to him. So, Tom, Alex wants your thoughts on this.
The shiplap, for one thing, is structural. So as you take it down, you have to replace it. Hopefully you're doing that. There's been cases where people started removing the shiplap and the homes have collapsed on them and actually killed them here in the Houston area.
Yikes.
In the Heights and stuff. So be careful with that. That home, I would not bother insulating it, as old as it is. Let it stay dry. Why the termites were in there concerns me. That means there's some water penetration, or maybe at one time there was, and that's been fixed. But make sure you take a look at that to make sure you're not getting water in those walls, because the termites will come back. But as far as that goes, I wouldn't insulate it. That's an old home. It's going to have a lot of character to it. When you have the shiplap, the airspace, sheathing on the outside, you have brick, you have sheetrock when you come back with it. You got a lot of stuff that adds up to an R value that a little bit of insulation in the wall isn't going to make too much difference. Now, the attic with radiant barriers and ventilation and the where the sun shines through and really heats up the home, that you'll have an area where you can let it breathe, put the radiant barrier in, put your insulation in, and that will help tremendously.
So you'd blow in insulation in the attic?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
As long as they have a lot of ventilation, and a radiant barrier would be a lot very beneficial to you.
All right. You have questions? You want beneficial answers? Please just send us the question to homeshowradio.com using the Ask Tom form. It's at homeshowradio.com, all right? And we'll answer it like these videos over here.